he spoke to scientists who did works to prove that evolution is wrong or to prove there is a creator. They had to tell him, listen, you have to leave. So what's happened? Why mentioning this? You should watch it called the expelled ones. The expelled ones, yeah? Why I'm mentioning that? What's happened in our time? Those who want to manipulate us and control us and turn us away from our creator, they are utilizing two things, media and education. Because that's the best way to manipulate the people and control them. So now what they're pushing in schools, universities, science is a fact. Darwinian evolution is a fact. Even though it's a pure belief. It's a belief based upon assumption, clearly. Because why? As a brother, I will explain to you about science based upon observation. You understand? So they cannot, I mean, one of the scholars said, Sheikh Fawzan, he said, okay, how many years this Darwin evolution? How come it stopped as a human being? Why are we not evolving? They're going to say because, of course, they have explanation.
We are evolving.
Yeah, no, so how are we evolving?
Okay, you see wisdom teeth.
Okay.
Do you have wisdom teeth?
I don't know, I haven't checked it too many. I don't have time to check it, but
right,
anyway.
Right. Back like on Homo habilis and stuff, we used to eat like leaves and grass and stuff, so that those wisdom teeth you know, those sort of leaves. But nowadays, you see people, some of them were born, some of them were without. Like some sort of evidence of evolution.
No, that's adaptation. That's not evolution.
Yeah, you mix it between evolution and adaptation. Evolution, adaptation is not the same. Okay. Evolution, that's why if you ask, can you give me a living example? Because what is the Darwinian evolution? Darwinian evolution, that's why even Richard Dawkins, what he said, when he was asked this question, how come we haven't seen one species evolving to completely different species? He said, due to the time. You see, due to the time, we cannot observe that. So are you telling me there's not any species, it's time for it to move or to evolve to complete different species? There's no, that's what I'm saying, okay, just pure assumption, pure khurafa. The biggest khurafa, you know khurafa? The biggest hallucination is Darwinian evolution. And I'm telling you.
As a scientist, he actually admitted, this is on admission, he said, we as scientists know that the theory of evolution is not satisfactory in explaining observations. But the reason, and this is proven the point we were making earlier about the philosophy of science, but the reason we accept the theory of evolution is to keep the vine foots out of the door. He's clearly telling you what his agenda is. He said agenda is, I don't want there to be a creator in the discussion of what's of the observation. So therefore, we have to rely upon the theory of evolution. But if you do some research, I'm not talking about like going into a school textbook because they're going to hide from stuff a minute. And this is not even a conspiracy. It's actually true. They do suppress evidence. There's no suppression of scientific evidence. But if you do actual in-depth research, there's a book called Darwin's Black Box, and that is a fundamental flaw in the theory of evolution. They cannot, because basically. The way things of like adapt here is, let's say take the human eye. The human eye has certain things in it which, if it's not there, it will never exist in it. But because when Darwin came up with the theory, they didn't understand things like cells and how they were. So they found the cell, the human cell, works like a motor. And I don't know if you know anything about electrical like sciences, but like so, there's no way a generator or a motor is gonna come by pure chance. Way too complex, isn't it? Your human cell works exactly the same like that. And if it's missing, so like if you have a generator and you take out some of the coils in it, that generator is not working. You're not gonna get the magnetic field in it.
But which one was us?
So if you take out some of the parts of the human cell, that human cell is not gonna evolve. It can't evolve in it. And that's what he called Darwin's black box. There's also something called the Cambrian explosion, which is.
It's not gonna record you, but I just your voice.
So if you research the Cambrian explosion, what this was is they basically looked at the fossil records, because everyone's touts fossil records as the proof of evolution. Hold up a second, let's take a step back here. We know in the fossil records, there's not enough time and not enough fossils for there to be all the species we see today. So what did they had to make an ad hoc assumption, which in science, that's not how it works. You don't make ad hoc assumption in science, you prove, and then you go from there. You establish the evidence, then move in it. You make an assumption, then move. So they made an ad hoc assumption and say, okay, what we're gonna say is, there was a sudden explosion, sudden inflation, if you want, of species, and there wasn't enough time for them to settle into the fossil records. That's not science, but that's belief. And going back to the definition of science, if it's not repeatable and it's not falsifiable, that's religion now. You're starting, not you, I'm saying, but an evolutionist doesn't realize he's starting the same person as, for example, a Christian. Because a Christian is starting at a place of, okay, well, we believe in God, and God's not false. You can't say God is falsifiable. God is the truth in it. So what's the evolutionist doing? He's based on assuming that evolution is correct. But you have to prove evolution is correct. But us as believers, we don't have to prove Allah why, because it's inherent in human beings. We as humans, we know by pure instinct, I don't have to tell you, I can live on an island and you grow up believing there is a creator. That's the first evidence. Secondly, the pure common sense tells you, for example, if I pull out a gun and shoot you, you're not going to look at the gun, you're going to look at me. Do you know what I'm saying? So why are you, like, for example, why are you looking at the creation? Like, it's like taking a brick. It's got a wall of bricks, and you only look at one brick and you say, this is the creator of the wall. No. You've got to look at the whole thing and say, hold on a second, there's too much intricate design knowledge here to just look at one brick. Do you know what I'm saying? So that's what evolution are doing. They're taking one little thing and running with it. It's like, no, hold on a second, take a step back. Don't make ad hoc assumptions.
The very mechanics that they are acting upon clearly relies upon belief in a creator to work. Look, just to, another example that you mentioned about these people that are at the highest levels of academia that yet have a religious, like an anti-religious assumption. This guy known as Peter Atkins.
Yeah,
Peter
Atkins.
He said, even if the stars were to align and say, Peter, believe in me, he said, I'd just rather say I'm mad. Rather say I'm mad. So this is so.
You get it, yeah?
Do you get the point?
Yeah, yeah.
If the stars were to align and say, Peter, believe in me, he would say, I'd rather believe I'm mad than believe there's a creator. And this is what we mentioned in the Quran. If Allah was to send down a stairway from heaven, they would steal this belief.
And there's the media who are pushing to us as the best the scientists.
He's one of the highest people in Oxford. Okay, one of the high. What's his field?
Is he chemistry?
He's at Oxford, sitting in one of the highest chairs in Oxford. So these are the levels. These are the kind of people that we're relying on for our belief to judge the Quran. Can't. No way. No way. We have we stand on our own square. So this is basically in conclusion.
And you know, it's the beauty of Islam as well. About why Islam is the truth. Why there's a creator. There's something called universal proofs. Universal evidences. You know what is universal proofs? Universal knowledge. What's your name again, Smiley? Mohub. You know what is universal knowledge, Mohub? Universal knowledge, regardless who you are, Christian or a Jew or a Muslim, you're born with it. For example, naturally you know that for something to come into existence, must have what? Creator. That's naturally is known. Okay? The proof for that, we call it the effect and the cause. Okay? Or could we call it, for example, the creation, the creator. If there's a child and you hit the back of his neck, the child start looking who hit him. Why? Because he knows for effects must have what? Someone that caused it. How he knew that? Someone said no, you learn it from the environment. That is incorrect. Because the baby is too young, is 2 years old to learn from the environment. It's something which is naturally within him, inherently. The other one, that we know, that two contradiction thing, it's impossible for something to be perfect or imperfect at the same time. Or something to exist and not exist at the same time. Or something to exist one place, same time, exists another place. Okay, same thing. The proof of that is inherently we have it. When a child, a baby, 7 months, 8 months, start looking for her doll or for his doll, if he finds the doll, he will not start looking for the same doll somewhere else. Why? Because he knows inherently this doll cannot be here and there, same place. That's inherently, you see. And this is what we call al-fitra, which Allah said, فِطْرَةَ اللَّهِ الَّتِي فَطَرَ النَّاسَ عَلَيْهَا لَا تَبْدِيلَ لِخَلْقِ اللَّهِ. That's why look to Islam. Allah gave us universal knowledge. When you look to Christianity, Judaism, Hinduism, every ism doesn't go in line with our universal knowledge, which the Creator has put in us. Rather goes with Islam. Worship your Creator, who is perfect and according to His way. Not God become a baby, someone church is nappy. You understand? Or you know, literally, Mahubia, speaking to one guy yesterday, he's an atheist. He said to me, it's possible for this creation to create itself. I said to him, if the creation never existed, non-existent, it was a non-existent, how is it going to create itself? He said, it's possible. You cannot speak to someone like that. Because by definition, it's not there. So logic dictates something else should bring it into existence. And that's what Allah said, أَمْ خُلِقُوا مِنْ غَيْرِ شَيْءٍ أَمْ هُمُ الْخَالِقُونَ أَمْ خَلَقُوا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضَ بَلْ لَا يُوقِنُونَ. Were they created by nothing? Nothing is not even a thing, let alone to create something. Or to create yourself. You know, it's funny because I was speaking to one guy, he wants to be stubborn. He said, yes, I created, my parents created me. I said, you sure? He said, yeah. I said, how come when you die, your parents cry for you? Why they cannot give your life back again? Wallahi. You know what he said to me? No, do you know what? I'm not gonna, there's no death anyway. He had to negate what is known by necessity. So this person, that's what Allah said, you know, Surah Musa. قال رب السماوات والأرض وبينهما إن كنتم موقنين. Okay, let me ask the brothers here. Why Musa عليه الصلاة والسلام said إن كنتم موقنين? Why didn't say إن كنتم تعلمون? Because the scholar said, he's telling them, if you're not certain about this creation, must have a creator, then you don't have no certainty anymore. If you're not certain about something which is well observable, must have a creator, you can't have certainty about anything. And that's what's happening with atheism now. Atheism, true atheism, leads to subjectivity. There is no certainty at all. Everything is subjective. What is true to you, so to you, but to me can be something else. Subjectivity is dangerous. Yes, there is some subjectivity. However, there is some stuff which is objective. You understand? Yeah. So the beauty of Islam, Akhi Mohoub, yeah? Islam, when Allah told us to believe in Him, to believe the Quran is the word of Allah, to believe Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, it did not tell us just believe and keep quiet. No. Allah, what Allah said? Allah give a challenge. Allah utilized logical argument. What is the logical argument the verse I mentioned? Even the logical argument against the Christians, why Jesus cannot be God. What Allah said, كَانَ يَأْكُلَانِ الطَّعَامِ. Both of them used to eat food. About Jesus and his mother. What does it mean? They cannot be God who is self-sufficient. Because the nature of self-sufficiency is not in need of nothing all the times. The fact that Jesus had to eat food and drink water cannot be the same God who is perfect all the times. Logical way. So we don't say to Christians, Jesus cannot be God because Allah said he's not God, full stop. No, Allah gave us a logical way why Jesus cannot be God. Everyone with a sound reasoning will agree with us. When Allah comes to the atheist, Allah gives us a logical proofs why atheism is irrational. When it comes to polytheism, Allah gives us logical proof, rational proofs why it's illogical. When it comes to prophethood of Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam, Allah gave us a logical proofs, rational proofs why he's a messenger of Allah. For example, Allah Subhanahu wa Ta'ala said, why the Quran is a miracle? Let me make it clear. Prophet Muhammad Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam came to people. They used to drink day and night. Day and night drinking khamr. It's like coffee for them. You know, Algerian, we love coffee.
Yeah.
North Africa, coffee every day. You know, for the Arabs back in those days, khamr is like coffee for Algerians. Drinking day, morning, evening. He came to them, they wouldn't know what? To get married or to have fornication with more than 10 women. All their life, he's coming to them, tell them, stop all of that. What is your proof? This book, Quran. Whoa, whoa, whoa. You would have stopped that, and this is a proof. He said yes. And if you don't, I challenge you to bring something like it. What is like it mean? In its eloquency, in its legislation, in its prophecies, in its structure. You know, the way do we have impact on people? Allah challenged them for 23 years. He challenged them in Mecca, in Medina, what the Arab pagans did. And before that, the Arab pagans, they used to have three markets of poets, like Speaker's Corner. You know, the Arabs had Speaker's Corner. How? You bring poetry between each other. So before you go to Souq Uqad, you have to go to the first market. So before you go move to Souq Uqad, market of Uqad is for the best poets. So imagine, like I hear Brother Ali said some powerful poem. So I say, you know what? I'm going to challenge him. When the Prophet Muhammad SAW came with the Quran, all of them became silenced. It's like they don't speak Arabic anymore. What they did? They wish a war against him instead of challenging him. Even though we know, in a war you're going to lose your family, lose yourself, wealth, everything. So how come they choose war and they left the challenge of bringing something like it? Because they knew that what our Prophet Muhammad brought is not from him. It's from the Most High and we cannot challenge it. So let us wage a war.
Also, the Quran gives you truths that you can testify to yourself. It's tangible truths.
So, yeah, for example, when Allah said He will preserve the Quran, that's a claim. That is a claim. You cannot tell someone Quran has been preserved. What is it Allah said? No, we can prove that claim. That claim, I've challenged everyone to do it, the Christians, the Jews. Let us burn our scriptures. Let us, for the sake of argument, I'm not saying we do it, yeah? Let us throw our scriptures in the sea. The only scripture that we can bring back is the Quran. Do you know who can bring it back? Not the Muslim scholars, the Muslim children. They memorized it word for word, letter for letter. And Allah mentioned that in the Quran, وَلَقَدْ يَسَّنَّ الْقُرْآنَ لِلذِّكْرِ فَهَلْ مِنْ مُدَّكِرٍ. we have made Quran easy to be memorized. Now you go to non-Arabs. They don't speak Arabic, but they memorize Quran word for word, letter for letter. How man that lived 1,400 years ago, he knew that his book would be memorized by everyone. They don't even speak the language. And we preserved because that was not his claim. That was the claim of the Most High. I was speaking to, just to show my brothers and sisters, those who are watching, as benefit, that we can prove why Prophet Muhammad cannot be a liar. Do you know why? Who can give me one proof why Prophet Muhammad cannot be a liar? Why? What proof? From his biography. Why he cannot be a liar? I'll give you one. The story of Ibrahim. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his son Ibrahim passed away. Okay? And the Arabs, that time, they were not familiar with eclipse. Eclipse, yeah? The same day, eclipse occurred, same day. So they say the reason there is eclipse, because Prophet Muhammad's son passed away. If he was a liar, what he would have said? You see, I told you. Look, my son passed away. Because they don't know nothing about eclipse.
Yeah.
My son passed away. Look what happened to the sun and the moon. Because the biggest liar would try to utilize any opportunity to back up his claim, correct? But what he said, what occurred, it has nothing to do with my son's death or anyone's life. What occurred is from the signs of the Creator. So what he did, he turned them back to the Creator, not to himself. That is not the characteristics of a liar. Another one, I'll give you another one. Prophet Muhammad, والسلام, his wife was accused to be adulterer. And we know, accuse me, accuse my cousin, don't accuse my wife. The one that we love more after our wives, after mothers, our wives. So they accuse his wife to be adulterer. What he could have done if he was a liar? He could have said, God told me that's not true. Same day, you know? Or God told me, oh my wife, because I don't like you anymore, I'm looking for an excuse, God told me it's true. Well, for 1 month, he's asking the people, what do you think about Aisha? People say she's a righteous woman, she's good, God, Messenger of Allah. Even Prophet is asking Aisha, if you commit a sin, ask Allah forgiveness. Aisha started crying for 1 month. Then Allah reviewed the verses, freeing Aisha. Personal say, no, you're not going to wait 1 month if you're a liar. 1 month, and it's the most hurtful thing. Likewise, another proof. Prophet Muhammad, Allah reviewed the verse, oh Muhammad, you will never get killed, or you will never die until you convey the message. This verse was revealed when the Prophet Muhammad was engaged in a war. Not when he was in his palace hiding, and the verse said, I'm not going to die. No, he was in the places when there's most likely he will get killed. However, they tried to poison him. They did. They put magic on him. They did. But they never killed him until he conveyed the message. He said, the message is clear. Now, if he dies or gets killed, khalas. Because why? The prophecy has been fulfilled that you will not die or get killed until you convey the message. And that's why there is no statement in any religion that Allah said, today I have perfected your religion for you. Except Islam, no Christianity, no Judaism. Make sense? SubhanAllah, that's why, you know, what we have to do, especially all of us in our time, we are shabab of Instagram, Snapchat, Facebook, Twitter. We are most of our life on social media. We now have to learn about Islam. You can't keep saying, back home in Algeria, back in the days, you can say, I'm a Muslim, that's it. Everyone's a Muslim. But now we live in a city or in a country when the people are going to challenge our belief. So we have to know why Islam is the truth. And alhamdulillah, Islam established itself. Is that clear, my friend? Yeah. الحمد لله مين من الجزائر انت؟
وهران
وهران انا من وهران
ايوه
مين من وهران؟ انت وهران؟
بلاطو
انا ملك مين؟
الله يبارك
انا مش بعيد عليك راك جاري
جاري
بلاطو وعندي صاحبي انا مبتلاك
انا فوت لارمي
هذا مبتلاك
انا فوت لارمي في الكمين سيكسيون سبور
في ليزاموندي
نعم
حدانا مش بعيدة
حوايج تعرف حوايج حوايج جدوكا
حوايج وين كانوا في الجهة ايش؟
في الكمين دوزيام ريجون
دوزيام ريجون
على غوش هو حدا حدا الكازيرنا بواحد
واحد جيت طورو
ايه
ما شاء الله راك جاري ما شاء الله
الله يبارك
فيك
شوف ما شاء الله جاري
ايوا ما شاء الله الحمد لله
هنايا حنايا بالك يوافقني بالك ما يوافقنيش احنا ممنوع نشوف هذه البلاد الا في ثلاث صوالح ولا اربع صوالح
الدعوه
الدعوه التمريض
المرض
ولا الدواء
ولا العلم يا طب العلم يا
هذا الواز ما عندناش حق نعيش به.
لا لا بصح كاين الان العلماء قالوا الا اذا هي الاحسن اوف كورس معروف احسن ايش لكن اذا انت عايش just can we speak English in English he was talking is it allowed for us to live in this country and he was mentioning the reason we only allowed if we are given da'wa or for medication reason or for seeking type of knowledge we cannot seek in our country back home. I said no, the scholar said if you live in a non-Muslim country and you are allowed to implement Islam then you are allowed to live, it's not haram for you. However, it's better off to make hijrah, no doubt. But it's not haram. But, you know, if you're giving, that's why I always advise my brothers and sisters, utilize this opportunity. That, of course, okay, you were born here, your father was born here, but utilize this opportunity, live in this country to give da'wah. Like in Algeria, all of them are Muslims. You understand? But here, there's a lot of non-Muslims. You can imagine, Prophet Muhammad SAW said, إِنْ يَهْدِيَ اللَّهُ بِكَ رَجُوًا وَاحِدٍ خَيْرٌ لَكَ مِنْ حُمُ النِّعَمِ. If one person became a Muslim through you, it's better than the world and what is in it. Imagine that. But that has to be done based upon knowledge. Yes. You have to learn. Why Islam is the truth? You cannot say to someone, Islam is the truth, because one day I was sleeping in my room and Prophet Muhammad appeared to me. No. This maybe happened, alhamdulillah, in your dream, yes. But maybe it's not Prophet Muhammad. No, Islam is the truth because Islam is based upon tangible proofs and a logical, rational argument. Alhamdulillah.
MashaAllah.
Barakallahu feekum. If you have any question or something, خلاص خويا مو.
لا
مش تلاقى إن شاء الله.
بتلاقوا في. جاني للدار.
تجوز كل حاجة.
في بيتنا جرين.
بيتنا جرين. بيتنا جرين.
Yeah yeah. Invite you.
ما كانش مشكل خويا قاع.
Brother.
انا عندي درس اليوم اللي بغيت نجيبهم نروحوا
ان شاء الله
اخوه ما شاء الله
المشكل ما عنديش لوطو انا عندي لوطو ما عنديش القانون